asked for help, but was denied a restraining order. Now that local woman is dead. Evening, everybody. I'm Jack Atherton.
And good evening to you. I'm Cherie Polello. Days after a Florida judge said no to that protection order, the Vevay, Indiana woman was gunned down by her ex-boyfriend. And tonight, the community came together to honor her. News 5's Laura Borchers was there. Laura?
Yeah, Cherie, just 22 years old, Lonnie Amber Turner left her hometown here in Vevay, Indiana. She went to school in Florida, but last Sunday when she didn't show up for work, her coworkers were immediately nervous. They feared the worst. Turns out their fears were right, and tonight her hometown marked her death.
If she walked in the room, everyone smiled.
She's a warm-hearted person that would give anybody the time of day. And in her short time, she's one of the best people I've ever met.
She's just going to be missed. Her whole personality was bubbly. She was just a sweet person, never had a bad thing to say about anyone.
Tonight, more than 150 people lit candles to honor the life of Lonnie Amber Turner.
She would always sing to me. The song she would sing to me is Irreplaceable by Beyonce.
Many wore her favorite color, one that also stands as a symbol for domestic violence.
There is no one that will ever take her spot. Never.
Amber went missing Sunday. Then earlier today, authorities discovered her body and that of her ex-boyfriend, Aaron Ross, outside of an Orlando, Florida hotel room. Motel guests told reporters they heard gunfire late Sunday night. Police say Ross had been stalking her, at one point even threatening her life. As her family and friends hugged tonight, they wish they could have had just a few last words with her.
Come home with me. We wanted her to come home.
At my worst point in my life, she was one of my only friends that was still there to help pull me back up and get me out of the hole I was in. She had my back, didn't judge me for a thing I was doing or what I did. She made me better, and now I'm thriving to be better for myself and for her.
And tonight, some of her closest friends went out and began making these ribbons. They say they're going to sell them for a couple bucks at a local photography business, and they're going to give all of that money to the family as they travel to and from Florida. Reporting live in Vevay, Indiana, I'm Laura Borchers, News 5.
Again, Amber had sought a court's protection. Last week, she requested a restraining order, but the judge said there wasn't enough evidence. The next step was automatically to notify her ex-boyfriend and hold another hearing on Amber's request. But victims' advocates say giving advance warning to accused batterers can be deadly.
It leaves a victim incredibly vulnerable for 14 days. It alerts the perpetrator that the person is trying to separate, trying to gain legal protection without giving them any kind of legal protection.
Advocates say it would actually be safer for the victim if the judge flat out denied a request for protection. That way, the suspect would not be notified before the victim could try gathering more proof.